In fact, some of the first Coast's men and women in blue have demonstrated that in a spectacular fashion. And in fact, joining us right now, Joy Bartley is here from Animal Care and Protective Services, along with Officer Tanya Nelson, to tell us more about this. Great to see you both, and you brought some friends along as well.
Oh, yes.
Thank you for having us.
You always do. Mm-hmm. So, Joy, so good to see you again.
Good to see you, Nick. How are you doing today?
It's our weekly event. I'm doing good. Tell us about this amazing thing that the JSO put together. Actually, it's really you. It started right here.
It's our amazing volunteer. I mean, our amazing foster parent, actually. We hook, line, and sinker. Six years ago for a foster parent. All of a sudden, somebody came out in the lobby and was like, we're out for Pet Meals on Wheels. Guess who picked up the slack? JSO came in and totally saved the day. I'll let Tanya tell you how much food they donated, because that's some good information.
Yeah, it's
right
pretty
there.
Amazing, right. isn't it, Tanya? How much did you get?
It was a lot of food. Altogether, my colleagues donated 1,700 pounds of dog and cat food.
Give us an idea. What does 1,700 pounds of dog food look like?
It was huge. It was absolutely huge. I've never seen a pile.
We've got a picture. That's 600 pounds.
That is 600 pounds.
So times three. Yeah.
Yes, times three.
And a little
three.
More.
Yes.
Three deliveries. This was only one.
Yes. And these are just donations from JSO, is
that
right?
All donations from the employees of the sheriff's office, yes.
Fantastic. And what was your, so you went in, you saw they needed food. How did it happen?
Well, through my fostering, I learned about the Human Meals on Wheels program through family and just being in the community. And then I learned that the Animal Control had started the Pet Meals on Wheels program, because for many of these older people, their little dog or cat is their only companion. And we learned that they were sharing their food with their pet. And some of them couldn't afford to feed their pet, so they were having to surrender it to the shelter. So they started the Pet Meals on Wheels. Well, I was there one day to pick up a foster dog, since I've been fostering sick animals and behavioral animals, and I heard someone say that the program was out of food and they'd be unable to do their distribution. So this little light bulb went off, and I thought, gosh, you know what? I have access to this huge pool of people. And you know, our agency being what it is, there's always some community or some charity or whatever, and police officers are always more than willing to step up and jump in and help out in the community where there's a need. That's what we do. You know, so I went to my chain of command and I got it approved, and I put out bins all over the city and hoped for the best, and we ended up with 1,700 pounds of food. It was great.
Stories like that are so inspirational, because it's one person. One person. You decided. You're like, it switched and you went, I'm going to do something about it. Imagine if there was two of you. Or
y'all,
three.
You know what give I mean? Me way too much credit.
What? Oh, no. Credit due.
I mean, anybody can do it. Anybody at any company can go. There's flyers on the website for Animal Control. It's coj.net. Mm-hmm. And you can print out the flyer, Pet Meals on Wheels, and post it up in your own company or your own office and put out a box yourself and pick up food.
Well, you're a great inspiration.
Thank you.
We have to meet these two beautiful dogs here.
Yes,
look
you
at
do.
Their eyes.
They're
I hope
wonderful.
You can see them, because they both have unusual
asleep.
Eye color.
Yes. And we brought some theme dogs. So we bought Baja, because we know it's Cinco de Mayo. And we also have Tula here. This is a 4-month-old baby. She's ready for a home. We are also doing, for the month of May, Mother's Day special. You can come and adopt a female dog for no adoption fee and just pay the $20 license. Mm-hmm. You also want to keep in mind that we have off-site events almost every weekend at the Pet Smarts. There'll be one down at the beach this weekend. And if you can't adopt a pet, always remember you can volunteer, you can donate food directly to the shelter, or you can come in and just give a donation with Friends of Jacksonville Animals, and that helps. It goes directly to the animals. So those are three ways that you can help without having to maybe take a pet home. But if you know somebody who wants to adopt, that's a way you can help too. Tell them to come to us and take a look at what we have. We get so many animals in every day, different breeds, different sizes.
Now we're coming up on summer, and yes. What is the age limit for a volunteer to come in and work?
13 years is the youngest that we take without a parent, and I love my team volunteers. They are very enthusiastic. They do a great job, and having them in there in the program is great. So tell them to come out, bring your kids. It'll be fun.
Great learning experience
great
for
learning
them
experience.
To get involved in the community. Absolutely.
Thank you both so much
yes.
for
thanks
all
for
the great work.
Thank you for having us.
To adopt and save an animal for Animal Care and Protective Services, you can call them at 904-255-PETS, which is 7387. They're located at 2020 Forest Street downtown.
And again, if you would like to learn more about fostering a dog or cat in need, you can download the foster application there at www.coj.net/pets, and then you can send it off to June Mason at masonj@coj.net. Also, as you heard, they will take donations of cat and dog food for the shelter's Meals on Wheels food bank. They need your help. It's a great way to help out. So just call for details on how you can become involved.
It's a gathering to help make sure the First Coast newborn babies are as healthy as possible.
How you can simply walk for a great cause. We have details after the break. We will be right back.
Thank you so much. Oh,